Lead and asbestos found in the juvenile court building.
By the end of this week, we could also learn a permanent solution for hundreds of displaced workers. They were kind of homeless there for a moment. That juvenile court, they moved down the street to 600 Adams Avenue. Action News 5's Kelly Cook got an update from Judge Tarek Sugarman about what's next for juvenile court.
Judge Sugarman says it's been a team effort to keep operations up and running, including the Tennessee Supreme Court, who offered up a courtroom for dockets to be heard. But within the coming days, there could be a permanent solution.
We are unhoused, but I have a dynamic team that's on the ground.
Judge Tarek Sugarman having to conduct interviews in his car instead of his office has become the norm. 2 weeks ago on Thursday, he, along with over 200 employees with both the juvenile court and the clerk's offices, were forced to vacate. Before the shutdown, juvenile court clerk Janine Gordon says some of her employees were complaining about feeling sick.
So I initiated that test on March 21st, and there was no way that I would know that it would end up with lead, mold, and asbestos.
Shelby County Chief Administrative Officer Harold Collins is hopeful the final report of the environmental inspection will be complete by Friday.
I asked the health department to give us the opportunity, if the air quality was sufficiently purified, to go back in and recover laptops, computers, and things of that nature. Just the hard items that we need to keep our dockets going.
There is a temporary plan in place. The public can file limited in-person petitions for custody, visitation, and dependency and neglect cases here at 600 Jefferson Street from 9 a.m. until noon Thursday and 9 to 3 on Friday. But efforts to find a permanent home has been more difficult. Judge Sugarman says his office has been considering a number of potential county buildings, including 140 Adams and open space at 201 Poplar. In terms of the juvenile court clerk operations, we were just told they have resumed most of their operations with the exception of child support contempt cases. Beginning Monday, they will continue issuing summons and subpoenas. Kelly Cook, Action News.